Welcome back. In this video, we will implement an even parity checker and see how error detection can be carried out with the help of an even parity checker. Subscribe to my YouTube channel if not already done and press the bell icon to receive the latest updates so that you do not miss any of my videos. Please like and share my videos. A parity generator is a logic circuit that checks for possible errors in the transmission. This circuit can be an even parity checker or odd parity checker depending on the type of parity generated at the transmission end. When this circuit is used as an even parity checker, the number of input bits must always be even. Let us now see how errors can be detected with help of parity checker. Let us consider that an even parity generator scheme was used at the transmission end. This means the transmitted data stream will have an even numbers of ones. Thus for input data stream A equals 0, B equals 0, and C equals 0, the transmitted data stream by using an even parity generator will be A equals 0, B equals 0, C equals 0 and P equals 0. The parity bit, P, is appended at the end of the input data stream before transmitting over the channel. Let us now assume noise is added during transmission to the transmitted data over the channel. This changes the parity bit, P equals 1 in the received signal, resulting in an error. Note that error can occur to any bit A, B or C. Since an even parity generator was used at the transmission end, an even parity checker will be used at the receiver end. The received data stream A equals 0, B equals 0, C equals 0, and P equals 1 is applied to the even parity checker. If the output of the even parity checker, that is PEC, parity error check, equals 1, indicates the received signal is errorly received, while PEC equals 0 indicates the received signal is correctly received. The truth table and expression for a 4-bit even parity checker is as shown below. So let's begin. The components required for implementing even parity checker are: power supply, a resistor of 220 ohms, LED, DIPX4 switch, breadboard, and XOR gate IC7486. Let us connect the power supply to power lines on the breadboard. Connect the VCC pin and ground pin of the IC to the respective power lines on the breadboard. Let us use the DIPX4 switch to switch the inputs. Since we have appended the parity bit P with input data bits A, B, and C, we will now require all the 4 switches of the DIPX4 switch. The parity check error will be indicated on the LED. If there is an error, the LED will glow. That's it, your circuit for even parity checker is ready. Let us simulate and validate the results. For input A to P equal to 0, the even parity error check is 0. When the parity bit is switched to logic 1, the LED glows indicating a parity error check has occurred. You can validate the truth table for even parity checker.